what still needs to be done, the challenges that are still before us. We come from a history of discrimination and a history of a disparate impact on African Americans and other people of color. So our focuses we've found are as general and broad as the American experience itself. If we think about what is a successful life in this country, we think in terms of one being able to get a good paying job and not discriminated against, quality education, one that would give every American an opportunity to have a good, high quality education as they pursue their future dreams. Home ownership, we know that wealth and wealth ownership in the United States of America is crucial. Race, ethnicity, gender, and other differences should not interfere. If we're looking at ways to fix these problems, whether we're talking about our criminal justice system, our education system, our housing and economic systems, whether we're talking about small business development, or we're talking about criminal justice, the issues that we're talking about all play a major role, and how they impact us has a tremendous difference. So the NAACP has a lot of different programs, a lot of different approaches. Because we are a membership-based organization, the input in both assessing what the problem is and crafting solutions to those problems really come from our grassroots up. We've got about 2,200 membership units throughout the country. We're in every state in the United States, but we're also still on military bases in places like Italy, Germany, Korea, and Japan. We know that this is a comprehensive approach that has to be taken on piece by piece. We know that we're part of a movement at the NAACP that began 112 years ago and continues to move to guarantee equal protection and equal opportunity for all. Our policies at the NAACP and initiatives are actually set by our members. They have recommendations for fixes. They can submit those. Anyone on an issue that we think might just be a problem in Atlanta, Georgia, we find because we have those from New York and from Washington State, we have membership units in Alaska and Hawaii. Believe me, I'd love to spend more time helping out with our membership in Hawaii. But with all that being said, they actually participate in that process, which also means they own the issues too, where we've been able to see real improvement, where growth happened, where opportunity was presented, where people were able to actually do better. Our healthcare system. At the time President Obama took office, one of his big issues was making sure that every American had healthcare. When we look at the breakdown by race, ethnicity, and gender, what we'll see is that people of color were disproportionately not provided healthcare. We knew there were some problems there and began down a process, what became the Affordable Care Act. Increasing our healthcare is something that we've worked on under many presidents and had a really hard time. At the time we put into place the Affordable Care Act, what some people refer to as Obamacare, into place, we saw the shrinkage of those uninsured. So it's a big deal. We continue to push forward. We want to see that system repaired and improved upon. So we've got to come to grips with exactly how those resources are being expended and how we can move to make sure that everyone has a real opportunity and no one is put in an extreme disadvantage. You can't do it with just one state or the other. We have to engage everyone. We can't do it with just local government. We have to include state government and federal government as well as we're looking to fix these problems in the long run. Then we have a game plan along these lines that we're working with our friends in the Congress, with our friends at the state and the local legislatures across the country. We want to make sure everyone has that equal opportunity to fully participate and succeed.